yet another unidentified body on the shores of Lake Michigan. It had blood.
Authorities believe it is the latest victim of a potential serial killer. Michigan residents are urged to remain vigilant in the wake of these senseless murders. A witness to the latest attack has been transported to Unity Hospital, where she's undergoing May Oster, is said to be suffering from psychological trauma. The much-anticipated book, Fractured, by the acclaimed Dr. Jason Ballard, has shattered previous studies in the field of psychoanalysis.
If anyone can reach her, it's Dr. Ballard.
He's highly skilled in cases of this nature.
Police still have no leads at this hour in the hunt for a serial murderer.
Tension is rising in this normally sleepy neighborhood as police discover a new crime scene. In a surprise move, Detroit PD has assigned Detective James Harding as lead investigator in the case. Harding's troubled history has been well documented.
I'm close. I'm real close. I need to redeem myself.
Police have arrived on scene and are scouring the area. Police go door to door searching for clues. In a shocking turn of events, police now believe witness May Oster could be withholding information related to the case. Oster may hold the key to the killer's identity.
Miss, hi, I'm looking for a Dr. Ballard. Upstairs. Thank you. Upstairs.
I have him on the lithium, and he's having a weird effect with the clozapine, I think because he is a violent addict.
I'm looking for Dr. Ballard.
Yes. There's a few items to move if I can. If this is about the book signing, leave your home address. I'll have my office mail you a signed copy, okay?
It isn't. I'm Detective James Harding with the Detroit PD. I have a couple questions for you about one of your patients. Excuse me.
All right. Let's sit across the hall.
Was there anything mentioned, anything suspicious?
Anything suspicious? Dr. Payton conversations are confidential. I would need to see a court order before I could really help. Court order, all right. Patients with extreme conditions are confined for their own protection. Detective.
Protection?
Mm-hmm. They suffer from a multitude of conditions. I would know.
Been after this one for a while. And I want some closure.
You look perturbed. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
Nurse, would you escort Detective Harding to the seclusion room?
Yes, Doctor.
And Detective Harding, please don't upset anybody.
In a dark story that I can't escape. You're late, Detective.
I'm late.
You're late?
What am I late for?
You're late for your end.
Have you seen this man?
The jackal knows about them. Yeah. Jackal. The Jackal knows.
About them? You mean there are others?
Yes.
I don't have that in you. Who is the Jackal?
You've got to get out of here. Okay? Just leave.
Get out of here. Why?
Before it happens well, what? To you. Get out. Just go.
Well, what happens?
Just go.
Okay, I'm. Can you just tell me what you know? Nobody's gonna hurt you.
I can't. He's gonna get me.
I promise nobody's gonna hurt you. I'm with the police.
At the apartment when it started. She met a man that altered our entire existence. Life became a dream.
You know how I said I'll be busy later?
Yeah.
Well, I'll be busy making you dinner.
May Oster.
Thank you.
Something wrong? Oh, baby, you blacked out again.
Dr. Ballard.
Yes, good. See, things are coming back to you. Oh, baby.
We spoke before.
Many times. You remember Maria? She helps us around here. Huh? See, she remembers you. Thanks, baby. And so does my wife, Barbara.
Barbara?
Mm-hmm.
Barbara.
Blacked out again?
Yeah.
That's Goblin, making sure we don't ignore him.
I don't recall speaking to any of you.
Oh, baby, let me see your right hand. No more trembling. Oh, that's great. I'd be fine for the night.
The night?
May?
I want to go home.
You are home.
That's preposterous.
I'm Honey, see for yourself. Look at this. These are your clothes. Here's a picture of you. And over here is something you're very proud of. Here's your tennis trophy, remember?
My boyfriend.
Your boyfriend.
I need to call him.
Oh, baby, you've been dreaming. That's a hallucination. Take two of these, and everything will be great.
How did I end up here?
Well, you were destroying him when the medics brought you to the hospital. After conducting several tests, it was apparent your case is unique. To a better understand your condition, it was in your best interest to bring you here and to monitor your condition. You've been here for 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Mm-hmm.
And some medic?
You tried to commit suicide.
That's absurd.
Well, you'll be all right now. First day of therapy today, okay?
Therapy?
Yeah. That's where you meet all the others.
So there are more. Dr. Ball. Do you think that I'll try to kill myself again?
That's what we're here to find out.
Check on Goblin.
Feeling better, May?
Yeah.
This is Bella. And with the flag, that's Gina. And this, with the book there, is Maddie. Okay, ladies. May is now a part of our group. Her case will only add to the diversity.
Dr. Ballard, let me be frank in saying that. I don't feel too comfortable around fresh sickos.
Your choice is like your taste in decorating.
It stinks.
Barbara won't like that. Okay, we're here to break ground in the field of psychoanalysis.
I think you're making a fool of yourself, professionally.
Don't be rude, okay?
Bizarre.
Bizarre. Noted. I only do this type of therapy on patients that are special to me.
And we're so flattered.
May's case will only help the group understand the complexities and problems that face young women. No need for insecurity.
Not insecurity, Dr. Ballard. I take offense to that.
I remember when Maddie first joined, how you both reacted. Am I right, Bella?
I'm fine with it as long as she understands we have seniority.
On the contrary, You all can be her peers.
That's fine, I guess. As long as she understands, we're not gonna be friends.
Now let's talk about a problem that faces women these days. Okay, during our last session, Maddie, you said, men are thorns.
Men are the problem, period. I blame them for my jealousy, my insecurity, my loneliness. The reason I masturbate so much.
I believe that stems from hate, a result of phobia. One's negative past experience with the opposite sex may lead to mistrust, blame, even fear. I think May is going to be a catalyst for successful research. I really do.
Yeah, congrats, fuckhead.
You're the chosen one. Makes you a target.
Maddie.
Did you do something mad?
Gina?
That's it.
May?
Paranoid, soon fear.
One more comment.
You can go to hell.
Want to be relocated? Didn't think so.
I can't do this.
Okay. We are done for today.
Place me in another group. I can't handle their whole macho hostility thing.
You look so worried. Is there something you're not telling me?
I don't know. I think I did try to kill myself.
Look, you knew they're threatened. They just have to get to know you. It'll all be fine. In time, it'll work out, trust me. Hey, look, I'm on call at the hospital tonight. If you need me for anything, just dial this number, okay?
I don't think I can trust you.
Barbara. She's a trained nurse. She's worked with me many times in these kinds of situations. Okay. So what are you up to today?
I may drop by the market. Why?
Just asking. Thank you.
What have you done, May?
This week. You said you'd do it. That was the plan. Don't worry, I'll take care of her.
Would brush it off as one of her blackout episodes, and Barbara, she's just suspicious of her. Yeah.
But she seemed sweet on her. Decent.
Jackals aren't decent.
Ladies? Ooh, let's get started, shall we? Everybody getting to know one another this morning? Now, this group will benefit once we find and contain everyone's individual, what's the word I want? Problem? Conflict? Confusion? That being said, I hope you all understand I'll be reminding each of you of events you may have wanted to suppress. So, May, tell us more about your past. Perhaps about a pet, a friend, maybe a boy.
I don't want to talk about that today.
Regression is understandable at this point. Ladies, it's not my intention in presenting anything malicious about any of you. That's fine, May. You don't want to talk, I understand. How about Gina?
Oh, the pressure.
No pressure.
History. At the time, I desired to remove myself from the dark despair that encompassed my life, and Europe became my euphoria. I was a bare canvas searching for my own colored life. Suddenly, I became alive. I met a brilliant student. You should have seen this guy. You married him, didn't you, Gina?
Several years in the marriage, though. It changed.
As people tend to do.
We relocated after I discovered a great job at a local university. We needed to escape our former life to reinvent our relationship. And as time eclipsed, we became happier than we had ever been. It was as if we drifted out of time once again.
Jen, you up? What are you doing? Wait, what are you doing? Stop, what are you doing? Stop.
Who is it this time?
Stop.
I gave you everything. I gave you my heart.
Don't. I said don't. All right? It's late. I'm going to bed, all right? You should too.
No more beds, Marcel.
What are you doing? Get off of me, please. Get off of me. Ah! Ah! Oh, fuck! Crazy bitch! In my face. Don't do this to us, all right? Getting too far for this.
One damp Sunday afternoon, I roused out of my happiness and into my current misery. I received a call. His slashed body was at the bank of a river 6 blocks from our apartment. To this day, the police never found the killer.
So sorry to hear that, Gina. Okay. Let's call it a night, huh, girls? Oh, honey, it's just a bad dream. That's all it is. Come here. Oh, baby. Okay, look at me. Okay, follow my light. Follow the light. Okay, good.
What's happening to me?
You're a young woman full of emotion, of life's disappointments. Past situations muddle your consciousness. It's nerves, May. It's nerves, baby. Here. Here we go. Let's make you feel better.
no more pills.
Please. They already dug your grave.
Get some rest.
Looking for something?
Just
good magazine, actually.
Your credibility just died. Sit. I've often contemplated the similarity of fear and desire.
You don't fear desire, Barbara.
You shouldn't either. Friends?
That can work. But without fear.
Are you ready?
For what?
For that match?
Oh. Okay.
10 minutes.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm just playing tennis, Gina.
Getting comfy?
What?
Fooling us with that face. One sly piece of shit.
You should be a motivational speaker, Gina.
Doesn't she make you feel right at home, May? What'd you do after the game? Go out for a drink?
One cannot deny the existence of hell.
What do you mean?
Means I'm gonna make you live in it.
Ladies? Bella, it's your turn today. We're gonna cover you whenever you're ready, darling.
What can I say about him? He had the kind of face you just wanted to caress.
There was a childlike persona about him that was magnetic. He was spontaneous, free, and uninhibited. His playful spirit lured the child inside of me, and this liberated atmosphere propelled my desire to write. It seemed as though he created the illusion I required in this world of disappointment.
Nothing is worse than broken dreams. He went to Yale to study English.
Ivy League dick.
I joined the Navy to win him back.
There was a party. I went to see him. Serving my country. Homecoming party. What was odd is when he got his degree, he came back.
And I took him in.
And you took him back?
Every orgasm with every fuck. He did that. Over and over. Again and again.
Lock that man down. Own it.
I surrendered to Brad and everything went back to normal. I doubt any couple were happier than we were at that time.
We're not working out. I want to move on. Leave.
It was the greatest chapter of my existence. It was as if I had lived an entire life in that moment because I worshipped every second of it. But I guess there is a time to die. I adored him. I adored him. I adored him. Reality of being poor. He took some pills. I found him in our tub.
I was called to serve in other wars.
Being a hero. It's not all it's hyped up to be.
Did you try writing again?
I wrote because of him.
Ladies, let's call it a night.
You did it and got away with it. Marcel.
I'd want you back.
To make a run for it, May. And if you don't get through, you have to just keep going. Just keep going.
It's gonna
Good people are the first to die. So tired, lonely, worried.
You're in on it.
Don't.
I should call the police.
Listen to yourself.
You saw them.
There was no one there, May. Telling Jason or the police will make you look foolish.
I heard you on the phone. You said, I'll take care of her and end it this week. What are you talking about?
Human blood. Not exactly a storm in a teacup type of a thing, is it? Hiding something, May. Secrets protect us both. You saw nothing. You heard nothing. Clear? Take your pills. Good night.
How did they get into the house?
Barbara gave them a key. They were watching. They stalked May like wild dogs.
So did May tell the doctor?
It was difficult for her. She was given pills to make her more manageable.
Barbara. There's no nobility in innocence, May.
I don't feel that way about you.
I'm sorry. You loved him. But you chose to kill him.
I love him. I couldn't have killed him.
Couldn't? You're unsure. It was in the news, May. A body found in the lake. Was the one missing from the apartment.
You're lying.
And you're so sane, right?
There are people that do you good, Barbara.
Don't fuck with me. I'm your genetic superior. Your suspicious bloody scarf. Now watch.
nothing. You heard nothing. Understand?
I saw and heard enough.
You better back off my shit heap or I'm gonna get that 12 gauge and I'm gonna fucking dust your ass.
Sleep
is your enemy.
Ladies. Let's move on. Maddie, it is your turn. Tell us why you are here.
I don't want to remember. I'm sorry, I'm picking someone else.
Maddie, we are all here for you. Go on.
I loved tuning pianos. I was a piano tuner. You'll go from schools to colleges and piano is an instrumental force in evoking a sense of love. But as it turns out, being content wasn't enough. And he smiled at me. It was perfect. I forgot the world. I knew then how lonely I was.
It's beautiful.
I teach also. Classical, mostly.
Oh, I wish I could play like that.
Let me teach you.
Really?
It would be my pleasure.
Okay.
Start with the same.
Okay.
There.
Difficult to concentrate.
Sorry, well, let's try this one then.
He was absolutely beautiful. Like that. Like the music he played. Magnificent.
I didn't want to leave that moment. I felt a fervent pull toward this man. Tune in both of our souls joined harmoniously. And just like that, I was teaching him. It was beautiful having him sitting next to me. We lost ourselves in the music. I didn't want him to forget me, so I focused on teaching him. In the end, he became a remarkable pianist. I wanted him to be better than me. Inside of my heart. The music he played filled my veins with a deep red current. It's beautiful. What's it for?
Sit with me. For bringing that old piano back to life.
sell me your piano.
Why?
So you'll have a reason to come play with me. He was mesmerizing. Adorable. While watching him play, time halted. Everything I thought I knew about passion subsided. I could stare at him every minute of every day. Unfortunately, that feeling came to a sudden crash. He was involved in a drug deal that went terribly wrong. A motorcycle gang threw his live body off a bridge. His remains were found 6 days later, washed up on shore. You can't imagine what that did to me.
He was a douche.
Don't be harsh.
Elitist snot.
That's enough, Maddie.
She's going to twit.
She'll be back. She knows what's good for her.
Things have changed, haven't they?
What do you mean?
Join us.
For what?
Dummy, when he's done with us, he's making sure we're all locked up.
Ballard's insurance plan is nifty.
This is all so wrong.
Yeah, listen, nobody here in particular likes you. You can change that.
You're all a curse. If you had anything going for you, Gina, why would she come on to me?
You guys, as of today, little May isn't as deep as we are. You try going to the police. They'll accuse you of being part of the plan.
Tell me, May,
I'm a murderer?
Don't you dare lie.
I think that you all killed your men. And you got away with it.
Wow. Your micromanagement skills are impressive. Now for sure you're one of us.
I'm on my own.
Wow. Welcome to hell.
Oh no.
Oops.
Hey, girls, help me carry. She'd like that again. Here we go. Got her feet. Here we go.
Would you stop dicking around with her, huh?
Me?
Stick to the plan, bitch.
No, do not call the police. They already know everything, okay? Do not call the police.
I don't understand.
My work, it's not complete.
Screw your book. Our lives are in danger.
You've got to believe in what I'm doing.
I don't know who to believe.
It's payback time. He's done with.
Now, before I drop your ass, are you in or out?
What?
Okay.
Okay, what?
I'm in.
goes down tomorrow.
I like that, Bella. It's progress. All right, May, I believe it's your turn to share. Has there ever been a boy in your life? May? May?
It was Christmas when he brought me to his cafe. He was lonely, just like me, but he held himself with dignity. He had nothing to drink but tea, but we drank for hours, just looking at each other. And he winked at me. He smiled so softly that it went right through me and out the other side. The softness in his voice struck me immediately. It was the voice I had prayed for. It was like a whispering, but deeper. Like the sound of a breeze playing over the open end of a glass bottle. A light was ignited in my soul. I knew only a fool would let this slip away.
Beautiful.
I'm still trying to recover from that moment. It was like a childhood song. Just unforgettable.
So what happened?
I kept going back for more tea, and he kept smiling. His words melted on his lips. The type of love we shared only happens once. And when he touched my face, my mind melted with the thought of him. I wanted to wake up next to him forever. With butterflies in my stomach.
So how did you get the bugger?
It was perfect.
I couldn't have asked for more. We started going to his favorite places. It was thrilling. A charge of bliss surged through me. We found poetry in the island. My eyes, once opaque, were suddenly colored bright in a hue of beaming happiness. He awakened a vision of a new world and, ultimately, a new me. I found myself falling. Christmas doesn't last forever.
Then what?
Just voices. Playing with my head when he spoke to another woman.
Jealousy is normal.
Jealousy. I was possessive. Very. My heart fell 20 floors.
Was it him?
May?
I was supposed to make him dinner that night, and I woke up with guilt.
Girls out of the room. Out of the room. You stay. You sit. Girls out of the room. Out of the room. How fast can you move, Gina?
You planned this. And those bills you give me.
I want you to calm down right now. I have to know how you girls react or I can't help you. It's simple.
Dr. Bob, I think I killed my boyfriend.
Oh, baby.
To the police. Know what I did?
They do.
And you knew about him and the scarf this entire time?
Oh, yeah. I protected you from them. Look, I'm sending them back to the psych ward. Now you can go with them. Or you can go to prison. There has to be closure.
I can't believe I killed him.
Every man's got a breaking point.
job. A man has urges, you know. Mine are a little different. Mine require very, very sharp blades. I'd close my eyes if I were you.
So, she managed to survive somehow.
I woke up in here. And soon, he'll sedate them with those pills. Save yourself.
So she talks in that third person, huh?
Maostra has many friends in her head. The difference between this book and the others is that this is a complete analogy on May. Patients like her help us break new ground in the study of psychotherapy.
Yeah.
Oh, your signed copy.
Thank you.
Poor girl. Think she's a famous writer who won a Pulitzer Prize and a tennis champion.
And she's been here for 3 weeks?
Yeah. Her schizophrenia reflects a unique case of false fixed belief. Cause and response to three issues: auditory, commanding, and visual hallucinations. Who calls herself Bella Mostow, Maddie Todd, and Gina Stamp. Thinks she was married to Brad, Lance, and Marcel. Yeah.
So she must have had a very traumatic experience at some point.
Oh, yeah. Resulting in her multiple visual hallucinations. May created quite a world for herself after she got here.
So May is her dormant personality.
Yeah. She misrepresents every external stimuli and interprets all images and sound into fantasy, inventing stories using her past and present interactions. Yeah.
Have you seen them?
Once she was caught beating herself, in her mind she was imagining it was them beating her, but in reality, of course, she's beating herself. And once she tried to choke me, that's why she has on the jacket.
Jacket?
That's
mm-hmm.
Not true.
Jacket. She mentions, a jackal. Is that something you know about?
Who knows, right? Her post-traumatic stress disorder and manic depression are a direct result of abandonment by her mom.
The skin we found underneath the dead body's fingernails matched her DNA.
So she killed him, hence the jackal.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, the gloves that we found next to the body are a bit of a concern. The evidence found underneath the fingernails could have been planted. And not to mention the fact that she hasn't ever confessed to killing anybody. Foul play could still be involved. We're waiting on the forensics of the gloves to get back from the lab. But the real question is, where is that white scarf? What? Why are you looking at me like that?
I made a few calls. You were suspended twice from your duties. Disciplinary action. DUI, probation. Are you still on probation?
I am in the middle of a case right now. And I'm very close.
Is that a fact? Are you covering something up, Detective?
What makes you think that?
I should call the police. But I won't. Get out. Detective?
The lies I've told are to cover the truths I've lived, to survive. The person at the lake was a patient that escaped. And the jackal killed him.
Detective.
And soon enough I knew why.
That's enough, Detective.
The doctor pins murders on his patients. And he uses the pills to make us feel like we're guilty. Save me.
Hurry up, we have a tennis match.
Make sure you tell the detective about him.
Still going on about that? Time for your rest, man.
Yes, Dr. Ballard?
Barbara, I'll be out of town for almost a week. I have a patient I have to bring in. Make sure the May takes her medication.
For sure, Dr. Ballard.
You saw nothing. You heard nothing.
Thank you.
goblin. Do you think he'll visit today?
We found poetry in the islands. My eyes, once opaque, were suddenly colored bright in a hue of beaming happiness. He awakened a vision of a new world and, ultimately, a new me.